Today we are discussing the characteristics of the sound, and for that let us listen few audio clips. Chapter, we are going to discuss the characteristics of sound, audible and inaudible sound, and noise pollution, harmful effects of it, and how can we prevent it. We have discussed the term frequency. So very first, the different range of sound. It means many objects are vibrating. All vibrating objects do not produce sound. So that doesn't mean that they are not producing the sound, but our ear is not sensitive, not sensible for that frequencies. Means eardrum, as we have seen in the last video, will not vibrate at that frequency. Based on this, we are having three types of frequencies. First, less than 20 hertz, that is known as the infrasonic sound, which we cannot hear. Likewise, we are having the frequency greater than 20,000 hertz. That is known as ultrasonic sound. Our ear is deaf for ultrasonic sound. That means we cannot hear ultrasonic sound also. Later on, you will learn that this ultrasonic sound is having lots of applications nowadays in the field of medical, industries and automobiles. The middle one, which is left out, that is in between 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz, that is known as sonic sound or audible sound. That means we can hear only that sound. So three ranges of sound is there, which is dividing as audible and inaudible sounds. Now let us come to the interesting part of the sound, that is characteristics of sound. We are listening orchestra. In that, different instruments are there. All that instruments are giving their sound waves through the air only. That means they are passing in the same medium. Few of them are having same frequency or same amplitude also, as we have discussed earlier, the term frequencies and amplitude. Still, we are able to distinguish, to identify the different types of sounds of that instruments. Then, sometimes we are having pleasant sound, sometimes it is unbearable also. How these different types of sounds, or the last one as I had mentioned, which is known as the noise, the sound which is unpleasant to us, that is known as noise. These all the things are based on the different characteristics of sound. The first characteristic, that is loudness. The sound which is louder, it is based on the amplitude of the sound and it is expressed in decibel. It is the unit of loudness of this sound and symbol of decibel is dB. The waveform of this, if we are seeing, then this is having higher amplitude, this has lower amplitude. That means this sound is louder, this sound is softer. Now, if we are having continuously loud sound, the range of decibels till 60 dB, we can tolerate it, we can bear it. But if the sound is increasing beyond 60 dB, that means the sound of the machineries, the constructing sites are having so many sounds, different loud sounds, machine gun and other weapons, they are producing very loud sound which is having the decibels above 60, and that gives us some unpleasant feeling. Loudness, that is higher amplitude, that means more amount of energy is given to the ear. It has no concern with frequency. So, the sound of the roaring of the lion, that is louder, but the frequency of that sound is lower. So, what is that lower frequency sound? So, that quality of sound is known as pitch. The pitch depends upon the frequency of the sound. It is shrillness of the sound. That means if we are having this many frequencies in 1 second, the sound will be shrill. And that is known as high-pitched sound. Without seeing anyone, we can identify the sound of the male and female. So the female sound is of high pitch, while the male sound is of low pitch. That means frequency is less for that sound. After this, the beautiful characteristic that is known as the quality or timbre of sound. it enables us to distinguish one sound from another having same pitch and loudness. The pleasant sound, which is having rich quality, the sound of music, that gives us pleasant feeling, and as a result we can say that quality of that musical sound is very rich. In these musical instruments, there are number of frequencies are produced by one instrument. The common, the main frequency is known as the basic frequency, or harmonics word is also used for that. And rest of the frequencies are sub frequencies. We have seen tuning fork. Tuning fork always produces the sound of single frequency. So we are having another term, that single frequency is known as tone of that sound. While the note, see the alphabets are interchanged only. The note is a mixture of several frequencies. Based on this, we can conclude that a shrill voice, acute sound, remember these terms while you are describing the answers. A shrill voice, acute sound, and a sharp note is a high frequency or high pitched sound. While a grave voice, dull sound, and a flat note is known as low pitched sound. Besides this, as I have told, the characteristics of sound, that is mainly three characteristics: loudness, pitch, and the quality of the sound. As I said, that loudness is the sound energy which is passed to the ear. Likewise, the frequency, that is the number of oscillations. So the high pitched sound, shrill sound, is having more number of oscillations in 1 second, and that gives a sharp note. So sometimes that sound is piercing. And after that, we are having the last topic of the chapter, that is noise pollution, the harmful effect of noise, and how can we prevent it. As I said, that noise is unpleasant sound, the sound of the aeroplanes. Even in home nowadays, lots of appliances we are using, mixer, juicer, air condition, then washing machine, so many other instruments, appliances are there which are producing noise. If any factories are nearby the residential area, then the heavy machines of that factories are producing very loud and unpleasant sound. The waveform of this unpleasant, this we are seeing as a pleasant sound. But for unpleasant sound, this waveform will not be this much uniform. It will not have this much sharp shape. It will be distorted. And the time interval between these, as you can see over here, that it is uniform. but for noise it will not be uniform. This kind of sound makes us irritate if we are listening that for the longer time. That is decreasing our concentration, that gives headache, and the long term effect of this kind of noise can make the person temporary or permanently deaf, which is known as hearing imparting. To avoid all this, in this modern time, we cannot stop the noise pollution. As we have discussed air pollution, noise pollution is the next biggest problem for the urban lifestyle. We cannot stop it, but some preventive measures we can take. Very first thing that silencing devices should be fitted with heavy vehicles or heavy machines. These heavy machines should be kept in rubber form or any other sound absorbing material, so it will not leave that sound outside. Besides that, the industries can be relocated far away from the residential areas. Even we can plant the trees in our surroundings, which are also absorbing the sound or stopping the noise to reach to us.
आभार।